You're listening to the sounds of Salford from the UK going out to the world.
Hi, good evening and welcome to Noddy's Chosen Year 1981 Part 2, isn't it, mate?
It is, Simon, yeah. It's great to be back.
Happy New Year, mate.
Just before Christmas, there was too many songs in 81. It was such a great year for music, yeah. So we decided to split it in two. And the first track, I'm going to start on quite a melancholy note.
Yeah.
The song basically is about what was happening in the country at the time. What it was was Margaret Thatcher was dismantling the British manufacturing industry, and I don't know.
She was doing everything, wasn't she? She was fighting with unions all the time.
Oh, yeah, and this song basically is about the unemployment, and it was written specifically about the West Midlands, because the group who recorded this song are a Brummie band. I think you know them. They're named actually after the unemployment UB40. UB40. Yeah. Now, UB40 were formed in Birmingham around a nucleus of two brothers, Ali and Robin Campbell, and they had Brian Travers on trumpet and saxophone, and they had Astro, the West Indian guy. You know, they're a big band. And they started. This is quite a political song. First appeared the year before. I think it was Food for Thought.
Yeah,
was the first thing.
Great,
you know,
great song.
You know, but eventually they conquered America as well. And they had a couple of number ones. Like I said, Red Red Wine, I Got You, Babe, Kettle Falling in Love. You know, all cover versions. Like, but this is one of their own songs, and it really does encapsulate the moment of the terrible. Like I said, the privatizations of people. Yeah. Because I remember in 81, I think Alan Bleasdale brought out, or he was writing Boys from the Black stuff. You know, and that really did ram it home to people what was happening in the country.
Very similar to Ken Loach nowadays. He's very...
Ken Loach has always been like that, hasn't he? Ever since 1966 when he did Cathy Come Home.
Yeah,
And he's always been the same Ken Loach. He's basically a social commentator, isn't he?
Yeah.
And that's all he is. Like,
very political.
Yeah, but this song... It just drives the message home. So it's the first song since being back, and I'd like to dedicate this to my good mate Glenn. Glenn, this one's for you, mate. UB40, 1 in 10.
I'm a star. starving third world mother, refugee without a home. My housewife who can valley, my pensioner alone. My cancer-ridden spectre that's covering me, yeah. I'm another hungry baby, yeah. An accident of birth.
I am the one in ten.
A number on a list.
I am the one in ten.
Even though I don't exist,
nobody knows me,
but I'm always there.
Statistic, a reminder of a world that doesn't care.
I'm Adrian Morley, and I listen to The Sounds of Salford.
Yeah, I'd also like, so I forgot to mention at the start, I'd like to also dedicate that to a good mate of mine, Danny Grosvenor. And Danny's a big UB40 fan, like, so Danny, that one's for you. Now, we're moving on again, Simon, now, a bit more, well, I won't say upbeat, but it's not as melancholic, I suppose. Yeah. I think this is a beautiful song. It's one of my favourites by this band. Now, this band appeared in 1980 with a song called Enola Gay.
Yeah.
And it's obviously by Orchestral Manoeuvres in the Dark. And in 1981, they released what most people reckon is their greatest album, which was called Architecture and Morality. Now, the song I'm going to play is probably what I think it is their biggest ever hit.
Yeah.
But you don't really hear it so much now, which is, I think, is a shame. And this song's called Souvenir. Now, this song's unique in a lot of respects in that it's not many words in it. And it's sung not by Andy McCluskey, but by Paul Humphries. Andy McCluskey more or less sung nearly all OMD's work. But Paul Humphries sings this one. I always remember the video as well where Andy McCluskey's driving around this stately home and Paul Humphries is singing. I don't know where it was. I think it might have been Tatton Park or somewhere like that, or Chatsworth.
Yeah.
You know, but I always remember listening to this in the, I think it was late summer of the autumn of 1981 when I was at Pendleton College with Alan Burke. And it just always stuck with me. And it just reminds, whenever I hear this song, it reminds me of that time, which I think is a good thing. And I'd like to dedicate this to my good friend Colin, who now has only got 17 shifts to work.
What, before he retires?
Before he retires. Now,
that's one, Colin.
You know, so I'm pretty chuffed for Colin. I'm next week on the 73 show. I've got a special song for Colin.
Right.
You know, but I hope you like this one, Colin. This is OMD and Souvenir.
Thank you.
Yes, they were. Yeah, they still are. Yeah, I think they're still going, actually.
They're still going, yeah.
Yeah. I think they were one of the great synth bands. Mm. And what I was planning on doing work today was ask... See, my boss, Stuart, is really knows his electronic music. No, really does. Because he used to play a lot of keyboards. You know, I was going to... Stuart always gives me loads of dead interesting facts that I bring on the show.
Yeah.
So a lot of the stuff, you know, is what Stuart tells me. So I forgot to ask him. I wanted to ask him something about OMD because I'm pretty sure he's a fan.
I'll tell you what, it's a pity you didn't know us 2 years ago, because Birkin gave us a keyboard that was worth something like £400 that was given to him by Jean-Michel Jarre.
Right, oh, nice one.
I bet he'd have bought that. And we auctioned it off one night for charity for St. Anne's Hospice, and then we only got 100 quid for it. It was a belter.
Yeah.
It's worth miles more than that, wasn't it? Yeah. A Roland,
right.
Yeah, it was a top one.
Well, I always remember, like, when Alan used to bring his keyboards into Pendleton College, and he used to entertain us all of them. Because he was good then. Yeah. I mean, he really was good then.
I mean, he still is.
Yeah.
Still is.
Well, going on to one of... Again, this is a band that Alan championed in the early days. Now, these were at the forefront of the New Romantic movement. And they started... Or they first hit the charts in 1980 with a song called "To Cut a Long Story Short."
Yeah, ballet song.
You know, and then basically they came back in 1981 with a song called "The Freeze." Then in the summer of 1981, they come back with this next track. It's pure new romantic. The band was different to how they sounded later on, because Steve Norman was still on guitar. He wasn't playing saxophone then. He started to play the sax later on. You know, but I think it really does encapsulate Tony Adley's superb voice. I just love this track. I remember, I'm pretty sure my mate Rick Williams bought this. I never bought this song, but I wish I did at the time.
Yeah.
But this is Spandau Ballet, and I'd like to dedicate to my good mate John, who's probably driving home to Stoke now. So, John, this is for you, mate. Spandau Ballet and Muscle Bound.